we want to determine each product below. To do this, we'll be focusing on two properties of exponents. First, we have the product property of exponents. It says a to the power of m times a to the power of n is equal to a to the power of m plus n. This is telling us that if we're multiplying and the bases are the same, we add the exponents. And then the power property of exponents is here. It says that a to the power of m raised to the power of n is equal to a to the power of m times n. So if we have a power to a power, we multiply the exponents. Let's take a look at our first example. We have y to the third times y to the fourth. So we'd have y to the power of 3 plus 4, which is equal to y to the seventh. Notice the bases were the same, so we added the exponents. But we can also verify this by expanding these. What I mean by that is, we know y to the third is going to be 3 factors of y, so there's y to the third. If we multiply this by 4 more factors of y for x to the fourth, we can actually count the factors of y. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this verifies this product is correct. So if you're ever not sure about any of these rules, I highly recommend writing this out in expanded form. If you do this enough times, you'll understand why the rule works. Next example, we have 2 to the second times 2 to the third. Notice when applying this first property, the base does not change. So the base is still going to be 2, and the exponent is going to be 2 plus 3, which would be 2 to the fifth. Again, notice how we did not multiply 2 times 2 and get 4. The base stays the same, we add the exponents. And because our base is a number, we can actually evaluate this. 2 to the fifth would be equal to 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, which is 32. And again, notice how by expanding this, we can also verify that here's the 2 squared, and here's the 2 to the third. That's the reason why in exponent form, we had 2 to the fifth. And then because we had a numerical base, we could actually evaluate the expression. Next, we have 2 to the third raised to the second power. Using our second rule here, we multiply our exponents. So we'd have n to the 3 times 2 power, or n to the sixth. But again, let's go ahead and expand this to make sure we understand why this works. If we had 2 to the third squared, we know that raising something to the second power means we have 2 factors of n cubed. And then if we expanded n cubed, we would have 3 factors of n from the first factor and 3 factors of n from the second factor. And we can see we have 6 factors of n, verifying we have n to the sixth. Next we have 3z to the third power raised to the third power. This is a slight variation of our rule for a power raised to a power. I say that because the exponent on the 3 is actually 1, and we can see the exponent on the 3 is equal to 3. And since we have powers to powers, we'll multiply the exponents. So we'd have 3 to the 1 times 3, that's 3, and then z to the 3 times 3, that would be 9. And then we can evaluate 3 to the third, that would be 3 times 3 times 3, which would be 27. So this would be 27z to the ninth. Again, let's go ahead and expand this to verify that this is correct. We know if something is raised to the third power, we're going to have 3 factors of the base. So here we would have 3z to the third times 3z to the third times 3z to the third. Well, here we can probably see the 27 now, 3 times 3 times 3. And then we also have 3 factors of z here, 3 here, and 3 here, a total of 9 factors of z. If we wanted to, we could expand z cubed as z times z times z, here, here, and here, and then count the factors of z, it would be 9. And for this last example, even though it's in fraction form, I view this as a variation of the power to power rule, even though there is this extra rule here. It says if we have a fraction raised to a power, we raise a numerator and denominator to that power. But again, when I see this, I see x to the fourth and 6 to the first. So we have powers raised to powers, So we multiply our exponents. So for the numerator, we'd have x to the 4 times 2 power, that's x to the 8th. And for the denominator, we'd have 6 to the 1 times 2 power, or 6 squared. We can evaluate 6 squared, that would be x to the 8th over 36. And just to verify this, as long as we know that if something is squared, we're going to have two factors of the base, we could have written this as x to the 4th over 6 times x to the 4th over 6. Looking at the denominator, we can see the 36. And then for the numerator, we have x to the 4th times x to the 4th, which using our product rule here, we can add the exponents to get x to the 8th. Or if we needed to, we could expand this. We'd have 4 factors of x here, 4 factors of x here, for a total of 8 factors of x. Okay, I hope you found these examples helpful. Thank you for watching.